Right. I want to talk to you about how to approach long answer questions, these unstructured questions that always come up somewhere in a physics exam. These are ones that just give you a little question and then are worth about 4 or 5 marks and ask you to explain an event or discuss what's happening. And the way I'm going to do that is like this. I'm going to give you an example. And it's a question, it's a very straightforward question. And it's a fascinating one. It's a fascinating one because it's one that everyone knows the answer to. And the question isn't, ooh, what's happening? The question is actually, where do the marks come from and how do we get them? Okay, so the question is this. A glass is pushed from a table. Describe what happens. What I want you to do, just pause the video, spend no more than 5 minutes just trying to write down what you think will happen when a glass is pushed from the table. Right, welcome back. Okay, now this question here, 5 marks. And I've given this question to a lot of students in a lot of classrooms before teaching them how to approach these long answer questions. And it's fascinating. It's fascinating because everybody knows what happens, but people have tremendous difficulty in writing down what happens in a way that gets you the marks. Sometimes people spend hours just writing these huge long answers and never putting down the key points. So it's a very specific way to approach this type of question. I'm going to teach it to you now. Something I came up with a few years ago and it works very well for breaking these questions down. It goes like this. You break down your answer in this format. Something happens which has an effect, which means therefore. So what do I mean by this? Okay, I'm going to run through what happens with our glass. As I run through it, feel free to mark your own answer. By way of an interesting thing, if you get more than 2 out of 5, I am massively impressed. If you get 0 out of 5, don't even worry about it. Because the whole point of doing this is to tell you how to do these questions. All right, so here we go. Let's look at it with that breakdown. Something happens. The glass is pushed off the table. No marks. That's just setting up your answer. Also, it's in the question. Why would you get any marks for that? So the glass is pushed off the table, which has an effect. The weight of the glass is no longer balanced by the normal reaction force from the table. 1 mark. Which means, this means that there is an unbalanced force acting on the glass. Its weight. 1 mark. Something happens which has an effect, which means therefore. Well, we know what happens when there's an unbalanced force. The glass will accelerate towards the ground, 1 mark, in the direction of its weight, 1 mark. The glass will hit the ground, and finally, the glass may break, 1 mark. Now be careful there, that last mark only exists for saying the glass may break, not the glass will break. Because it might not. It might just bounce on the ground and be absolutely fine. So let's look at our answer. The glass is knocked from the table. The weight of the glass is no longer balanced by the normal reaction force from the table. There is an unbalanced force acting on the glass, its weight. The glass accelerates towards the ground in the same direction as its weight. The glass will hit the ground and the glass may break. There you go. Good job.